My, it certainly is a hot day here in Pocoyo's world. Oh, and look, there's Ellie. Looks like she's trying to keep cool.
Hello, Ellie.
You haven't seen Pocoyo today, have you, Ellie? That's strange. He usually enjoys the heat on a hot day. I know. Maybe he's with Pato. I'll see you, Ellie. And there's Pato. I believe Pato is trying to keep cool, too. Pato, you haven't seen Pocoyo, have you? Pato, but was that a no or a... sorry, Pato, I still didn't quite catch that. Are you saying... All right. I'll keep looking then. Sorry to have disturbed you, Pato. Now, I wonder where Pocoyo could be. Oh, there you are at last. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Lula.
Hi.
And look, it's Pocoyo's musical flower.
Flower. Music.
Pocoyo just loves his musical flower. Did you know, I believe Pocoyo has the only musical flower in the whole world. Looks like it's empty, Pocoyo.
More music.
Yes, it would be nice to hear more music, wouldn't it? How can you get your flower to play more music if your watering can is empty, Pocoyo? Can any of you help, Pocoyo?
Get more water!
More water!
It seems the water tap has dried up in all this heat as well. At least you've filled up your watering can for your flower.
Flower.
Poor Pato must be terribly thirsty. Oh, Pocoyo, that's very nice of you, giving some of the water to Pato.
Flower!
Oh, I wonder what she's up to. Oh, now I see. Ellie's going to take a nice cool bath to beat the heat. What a good idea. There's nothing an elephant likes better than a nice cool bar. Oh dear, there's no water left. Oh, there goes Ellie's bath, and she was so looking forward to it. Oh, Pocoyo, what a good deed. You certainly made Ellie feel better. But shouldn't we see about your...
flower.
Oh dear. It seems that Pocoyo used up all his water helping his friends. Now there's no water for his flower. Thank you. Don't worry, Pocoyo. Maybe someone will help you. I think someone might be on their way right now. Can any of you tell Pocoyo who's coming?
I am Pocoyo!
Oh, well, that's very nice, but I think the flower needs more than... Look at that! It seems that when friends help each other, magical things can happen. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye! See you soon! Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
What are you two up to today? Oh, I see. You're playing restaurants. What fun! I can tell by her hat that Ellie is pretending to be the chef. So, Pocoyo, that must mean that you are pretending to be the waiter. Well, it seems that what you need now is a customer. If only there was someone who could pretend to be hungry. I think Pocoyo needs a bit of help. Do any of you see anyone who might be a good customer for Pocoyo and Ellie's restaurant?
Pato!
Yeah!
Welcome to Pocoyo's pretend restaurant, Pato. Won't you sit down? Oh, look what's on the menu, Pato. Noodles. That looks delicious.
Noodles!
Pato, it appears he doesn't like the pretend noodles. Ah, a nice bit of fruit for dessert. An orange. That does sound good, doesn't it?
Orange!
Oh, an orange. Balloon. Oh dear, I think Pato is rather cross. What's the matter, Pato? You're really hungry, but Pato, this is only a pretend restaurant. Yes, that's why we called it Pocoyo's pretend restaurant. It was make-believe. Oh, Pato, you were such a good sport for such a hungry duck. It is a shame we didn't have any real food to give him, isn't it? And he is really hungry. A real cake! Ellie, what a wonderful idea! Cake is Pato's favourite. Pocoyo, run and get him.
Cake!
Ah, here he is. Hello, Pato, old friend. Why don't you sit down and have a bit of cake? Pato, no, no, oh, Pato, no, don't. Pocoyo, Pato thinks the cake is a pretend cake. He'll drop it, I know he will. Oh, what can we do? I know, can all of you help us? Can you help me to tell Pato that it's a real cake? Oh dear. Pato? Ah, another satisfied customer. Hooray for Pocoyo! And hooray for cake. See you soon. Ah, what a beautiful evening it is. The stars are all twinkling so brightly. If you listen very carefully, you can just hear them. Do you see what I mean? Yes. And everyone is just settling down to bed. Luna and Pato. And look, there's Pocoyo and Ellie. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Ellie.
Hello.
It looks like they're just about to go to sleep too, listening to the sweet twinkling of... Oh, dear. That doesn't sound good. Pocoyo, Ellie, do you know what that is? What about all of you? Can any of you tell Pocoyo and Ellie what that is?
It's a star!
Star!
Really, but you see, that star fell at... Yes, it's beautiful, isn't it, Ellie? But that star belongs up in the sky. Look. Dear Pocoyo, we'd better try and catch up with Ellie so we can explain to her about the star. There she is.
Ellie!
Ellie, wait! Oh dear. Oh, good idea. I wonder if Pato's seen Ellie.
Pato. Ellie?
Ah, I wonder where Ellie is hiding. I don't think Pocoyo can see her. Can any of you tell Pocoyo where Ellie is?
Up in the tree!
Aha, Ellie!
Oh, poor baby sleepy bird. What seems to be the matter? Can't you sleep? But what's wrong?
Oh.
I think little baby sleepy bird misses the twinkle, twinkle of the stars putting him to sleep at night. I think everyone's having trouble sleeping without the twinkle, twinkle of the stars, Ellie. I think Ellie would like one more moment with the star. Oh, thank you, Ellie. That was nice. How do we get it back up there? Oh, yes, the vamoosh. Perfect. Uh-oh! Watch out! There! Right where it belongs! Good job, everyone! And now, everyone in the world can enjoy the star along with you. Doesn't that feel good, Ellie? Ellie, and hooray for Pocoyo! Night-night. See you soon. Oh, there are Pocoyo and his friends. It looks like they're building a tower together. Hello, Pocoyo!
Hi!
Hi, Ellie! Hi, Pato! Good catch, Ellie! Everyone is definitely working together to build this tower. Oh, what's wrong with Pato, Pocoyo? What are those funny noises he's making? Can any of you tell Pocoyo and the others what's going on with Pato?
Hiccups! He's got the hiccups!
That's right! Pato does have the hiccups!
Hiccups?
Oh, don't worry, Pato. Hiccups are nothing to worry about. But they are rather annoying. Do you want to get rid of your hiccups, Pato? Maybe together we can think of a way to help Pato get rid of his hiccups. Oh, sounds like Ellie might have an idea. Oh, what is Ellie doing? Oh, Ellie wants Pato to hold his breath. Nice idea, Ellie. Do you want to try it, Pato? Okay, Pato, take a big breath on the count of three. One, two, three. Well done, Pato. That should do it. Oh, dear. And it seemed like such a good idea. Oh, you have an idea too, Pocoyo. Oh, what is Pocoyo doing? Oh, I see. You think Pato can get rid of his hiccups by standing on his head. Well, what do you think, Pato? Want to give it a try? I say, I think this time it might have worked. Oh, well. That seemed like a very good idea too, Pocoyo. What's that, Ellie? Do you think hopping on one foot might get rid of the hiccups? What do you think, Pato? It does look a bit silly, but you never know. Perhaps everyone should jump on one foot to make Pato feel better. Well, it was worth a try. What's Pocoyo doing now? Oh, he's holding his breath, standing on his head, and jumping on one foot all at the same time. What do you think, Pato? Psst. Hey, come here. Pocoyo, while Pato is doing that, I might know a way to get rid of the hiccups, but it's a surprise and Pato can't know about it. One way to stop hiccups is to give someone a surprise. You know, like come up behind him and say, boo. No, come back. Pato can't know that you're going to startle him. It has to be a surprise. Oh, hiding. What a good idea, Pocoyo. Why didn't I think of that? I've got another idea. Why don't all of you help Pocoyo and Ellie say boo? So let's all say boo after three. Ready? One, two, three. Oh, our boo didn't scare him, but it started the tower swaying right behind Pato. Pato, watch out!
No hiccups!
It worked! The surprise that surprised everyone cured Pato's hiccups! Hooray for working together! Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for hiccups! Bye-bye! Oh no, now I've got them! See you soon!